Welcome back, Eagles. I'm Dr. Jeremy Plowman, the principal of Grain Valley High School, and we'd like to welcome everyone back. We're going to have an incredible 2014-2015 school year. Go Eagles. I wish that I could be like the cool kids, because all the cool kids, they seem to fit in. I wish that I could be like the cool kids.
Hello, Grand Valley. I'm Isaiah Childs-Akers with your promised Alex Franks. We have the honor of opening this year's GVTV broadcast.
It was sad saying goodbye to last year's seniors of GVTV, but with all the new faces this year, it's sure to be a success.
To start off this week's episode, we are going to check in with Timmy, our sports reporter, and see how Grand Valley spring sports are looking this year.
Thanks, Alex. Fall sports are well on their way as they have been practicing hard through the warm weather these last couple weeks. With many teams starting competition this weekend, the girls' golf team will lead it off Friday morning in the Warrensburg tournament. The boys and girls' cross-country teams will look to compete in their first race Friday afternoon at Lake Jacomo in a tri-meet versus Blue Springs and Belton. Girls' tennis will also compete Friday afternoon at Harrisonville as they take on the Wildcats for their first match this fall. Boys soccer and softball will both start their season Saturday morning in their respective tournaments as soccer will play North Kansas City and softball will play Liberty in the opening rounds of their tournaments. Last but not least, the girls varsity volleyball team looks to open up their season on Tuesday, August 26th at 7 p.m. versus Benton High School. Now we'll go out to Freddie Hernandez with some interviews with our student athletes.
Thank you, Timmy. I'm here with Noah Espinoza and he's going to inform us about this year's soccer season. So Noah, how does this season compare to last season?
This season we have a lot of good juniors stepping up to the plate this year since we lost about five seniors or so last year. So I think this year our juniors will take the plate.
What are you most excited for this season?
Not losing first round of districts this year.
Hi, I'm here with Sydney Shields. Hey Sydney, what sport do you play?
I play tennis.
And what are some things the tennis teams need to improve on this year?
I think we need to like really improve on just kind of like working together. We've gotten pretty close over the season, over the course of the season, so I just think we really need to work on getting together as a team more, so that's basically it.
Thank you, Sydney. Hi, I'm here with Kevin Keck off the cross-country team. Kevin, how do you feel about this season?
I don't know. It's looking pretty serious because we have a huge mental shift in where we want to place in state, and we're going to go after it.
So I hear you guys qualified for state last year. How do you think that's going to look this year?
Well, last year, all of our focus was just getting there, but now we're going to get there and leave a good impression by placing high in the ranks.
Thank you, Kevin. Now back to Isaiah in the studio.
Well, that sounds great, so don't forget to go out and support your GV athletes.
Speaking of sports, have you heard of the ALS Challenge?
Yeah, it's gone viral. How could I not have heard about it? But what does it have to do with GV sports?
Well, turns out there is more to the story than just dumping ice water on your head. It all started with a baseball player named Pete Freights. Let's hear what Maverick has to say about the challenge.
Hi, Maverick here from GVTV, here to talk to you about Pete Freights, one of the guys who started the Ice Bucket Challenge. Now, as you know, the Ice Bucket Challenge isn't just about dumping ice on your head. It's to help support ALS. ALS is a muscle deteriorating disease in which you cannot function properly. So I'm just here to tell you that ALS, the challenge, you need to donate money. It helps because everyone around the world thinks that you just dump ice over your head and it's okay. But you need to help donate money. So go to ALS.net and help donate $10 every time you nominate somebody. Thank you.
I'm not afraid. been a ride. I guess I had to go to that place to get to this one. Now some of you might still be in that place. If you're trying to get out, just follow me. I'll get you there. You can try and read my lyrics off of this paper before I lay them, but you won't take the sting out these words before I say them. Cause ain't no way I'm gonna let you stop me from causing mayhem. When I say I'm gonna do something, I do it. I don't give a damn what you think. I'm doing this for me. So the world feed it beans. It's gassed up. Everything's just stopping me. I'm gonna be what I set out to be. Without a doubt, undoubtedly. And all those who look down on me, I'm tearing down your balcony. No way fans are bust. Don't try to ask him why or how can he. From infinite down to the last relapse album, he still. Whether he's on salary, paid hourly, until he bows out or he just bows out of him. Whichever comes first, for better or worse, he's married to the game. Like a for Christmas, his gift is a curse. Forget the earth, he's got the urge to pull his from the dirt. And the whole universe. I'm not afraid, I'm not afraid to take a stand, take a stand. Everybody, everybody.
I almost think paying the $100 would be worth it.
Well, it would be doing something good for your community, just like saving kittens from a shelter.
Oh yeah, I heard that the Grain Valley Veterinary Center is offering a few kittens for adoption.
Well, let's head over there to learn more about it.
Hello, this is Alex Franks reporting from Crane Veterinary Center. I have here with me one of the adoptionees. How would you say life here at Crane Veterinary Center is?
Like, they're so cute.
Nope. Hey.
I'm Isaiah Akers, and I'm here with Dr. Kyle at Crane Veterinary Center. Dr. Kyle, tell us a little bit about these kittens up for adoption.
These kittens were strays. The mama cat came in from Blue Springs. Animal control had found her, and she had had a whole litter of kittens. So I think there's 7 kittens total. I think they're about 4 weeks now. And yeah, they're about ready to go to new homes.
And do these kittens come with free vaccinations?
They do. We'll have all their first set of shots and dewormers. So... they're not quite old enough to spay, but yeah, we can work those details out to get them spayed when they're old enough.
Thank you, Dr. Kyle. I'm Isaiah Akers. Now back to you in the studio.
I hope someone out there will find it in their heart to save these kittens from being euthanized.
To move on to a happier note, let's head out to Morgan and Kirsten with a special insight on the upcoming senior night.
Let's see what the senior athletes have to say.
Hey GV, it's Morgan Kilburn.
And I'm Kirsten Hill.
And we're here to talk about this Friday's home opener featuring senior night.
Don't forget to get there at 6 for the senior announcements and at 7 for the game.
Let's go see what some seniors think. I'm here with senior football players Jacob Miller and Joey Sedano. So, Jacob, how do you feel about kicking off the season with senior night?
I think it's a good idea in the fact that it'll be a good hype crowd for a first game and that it gets a distraction of senior night out of the way here pretty soon. So,
yeah. Joey, how do you feel about this being your last season of football in high school?
It's kind of sad, but I hope we all go out there and do the best we can this season.
All right, guys, what do you think the outcome of the game will be this Friday?
It's going to be successful with a W at the end of the game. So,
if everyone does their job, we should win.
Awesome. Can't wait to see you guys out there.
Hey guys, I'm here with senior cheerleaders Haley McDowell and Brittany Workman. Brittany, what are you most looking forward to this year?
Hopefully winning state for my 4th year and cheering on the sidelines with all my friends.
Awesome. Haley, what are you most looking forward to this year?
Making the most of my senior year and cheering at state.
Thanks, guys.
Hey guys, Trevor here with a couple big fans of Grain Valley High School, Seth and Luke Banks. They're here to tell us about tonight's activities during the football game.
Yeah, so tonight we're going to have tailgating in the parking lot at around 4:30 before the game starts.
All right, what will you guys be doing while you're tailgating?
We'll be grilling out hot dogs and hamburgers. We're going to try to get a ping pong table, and we'll have washers, bags, and hillbilly golf.
And I hear there might be sort of a dress code for the game tonight. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Yeah, tonight is senior night, so they want all the students to have a whiteout. They want everyone to show up in as much white apparel as they can wear.
All right, so make sure you're wearing your best white. What do you think the outcome of the game will be?
I predict that David Ali and his Eagles, 35, the Savages of Savannah, 21.
All right, there you have it. Eagles are going to come out on top. Thanks, guys. Now back to you in the studio.
Thanks, guys. Make sure you make it out to Grain Valley home opener for a great game senior night starting tonight at 6 p.m.
If there's two things that I love about this school, it's senior nights and the new wings.
Hey, I think Ryan has something to tell us about the recent upgrades to our school. Ryan?
This is JJ Clappin here with Mr. Gorillo, and we're going to find out his thoughts on the new wing.
I really think it's a very nice addition. There's a lot of space out here for collaboration for the classes, and there's going to be a lot of technology to help get students involved with the STEM classes here. So,
awesome. Thank you, Mr. Gorilla. I've been here with Adam Huffman, and we're going to figure out if he's ever confused by the new wing.
Oh, no, I like it. You know, it's pretty cool looking. It's got all the fancy colors, and, I mean, it looks pretty nice to me, so.
Thank you very much, Adam. Hey, I'm here with Hunter Rogers, and we're wondering, do you ever get confused by the new hallway?
Yeah, I like don't even know where I am right now. Is this the new wing?
No, it's not.
I was supposed to be there.
Oh, well, thank you, Hunter. I'm here with Blake Lacey, and Blake, what's your thoughts on the new wing?
I think it's cool. I mean, I like the design of like the glass classrooms and stuff like that, so yeah, it looks cool.
Awesome. Well, thanks, Blake, and this is JJ Clappin signing off. Back to you in the studio.
The building additions are not the only additions at our school.
For us upperclassmen, the lanyards are new too, and they are strictly being enforced. So here is Jake and Packer with more on the story.
Reporters Jake and Packer here. We're going to walk around, we're going to interview some people about lanyards and the policy.
Here in Grain Valley, lanyard is the new black.
Easy is his name and the boy's coming.
Straight out of Compton, it's a brother that will smuck your mother and make your sister think I love her.
Hi, this is Jake Ray reporting live with Mr. Steffens. Mr. Steffens, how do you feel about the lanyard policy and how they're being enforced?
I think this year is a lot better than we did last year, and we continue to get better at wearing them on a daily basis. The big thing I'm looking at is just students to step up and do what we're asking. I think we have pretty good reason. We have almost 1,200 people in our building every day. We want to make sure the right people in here, they're identified. This also helps with 1,200 people that teachers can see names, other students can see names. So I appreciate the students that are doing it, putting it on their neck every day, not a hassle to get it out of their pocket or their backpack. So I've asked teachers, you know, a lot of people want to have a discipline with it if you don't have it on. I've said we're going to change our culture in a positive way. No discipline attached to this. We're going to keep encouraging in a positive way to wear it, change the culture of our building. I know that over time, hopefully that'll kind of just become a habit and it won't be a big deal.
Okay, thank you. I appreciate it.
I'm here with Jacob Dietz. What's your stance on the lanyard policy?
I feel that they're trying to help, but I feel like there's other things they could do. I feel like lanyards are not what Grain Valley needs, but it's something they deserve.
You heard it here from. Hey, this is Alex Packer. I'm about to interview Roberts about the lanyard policy. Hey, can I ask a few questions?
Yeah.
How do you feel about the lanyard policy?
You love it? Why do you?
Because, let's say, I've had him in class before, but my memory's getting short, and I can't remember people's names. So he walking down the hall, and I say, let me see your lanyard. Oh, that's Carter.
Oh. Hi.
So it helps me know who's who, if you belong here or not. And that's important. And then, of course, I can identify the good people who are wearing Mizzou lanyards from the evil people who are wearing KU lanyards.
All right, thank you.
I know I wear mine.
Where is it now? Now there's a model student.
Thanks, Alex. So I'm sure you guys have noticed the TEDx youth posters hanging around our high school. And I bet most of you had no idea what they were for.
So let's go to Jasmine to find out a little bit about what TEDx Youth is and why it has been posted around Grain Valley.
Alex and Isaiah, I'm here with Miss Lamb to get the scoop on what happened at the TEDx event that happened this past weekend. Now, Mr. Lamb, can you explain to us what TEDx is?
TEDx is independently organized TED events that happen all over the world.
Okay. Now, do you have a favorite speaker?
I can't say that I had a favorite speaker, but I was most surprised by Tristan Cottle. He's a youth that raised $28,000 for Race for the Cure.
Okay. Now, are you planning or hoping to host any more TEDx events?
Yeah, we're hoping to do another one next year. We have to resubmit our license and a bunch of information and see if TED approves us for another license.
Okay, now I'm here with Mickey Sickle, a student who went to the TEDx event. Now, Mickey, what did you like about the event?
Everybody was really inspirational, and there was a wide variety of speakers, so it was fun to listen to.
Okay, I'm here with another student who attended the TEDx event, Sydney Thornton. Now, Sydney, what did you like about the TEDx?
I really liked the speakers. I thought they were all really inspirational, and they all had good messages, so.
Okay, are you hoping that they have another TEDx event?
Yeah, I think that'd be pretty cool.
Now, back to you guys in the studio.
Thanks, Jasmine. So now we are on to our final story. Cooper and Kyle have ventured around the halls and found some of the new teachers. Let's see who they found.
Hey, GV, it's Cooper, and I'm here with the new teacher, Coach Driscoll.
How are you doing?
So, Coach, have you taught at any previous schools?
Yeah, I've taught at middle schools and Independence, two previous.
Cool. And are you involved in any extracurricular activities?
Yeah, I'm actually the new head baseball coach here at Green Valley, and I'm excited about the season this year.
All right, sweet. Let's head out to Kyle for some new teachers.
Hey, GV, I'm Kyle here with one of the new teachers, Ms. Stewart, at Green Valley High School. So, Ms. Stewart, what do you like so far about Green Valley?
I'm really enjoying the block scheduling and getting to spend so much time each day with all of my students.
All right. And what class do you teach?
I teach language arts, so I have language arts 2 and a creative writing class as well.
All right. Thank you.
Now let's take a look at the rest of the new staff and see what they teach.
Hi, Eagles. My name is Mrs. Michael, and I teach pre-AP LA1, LA1, and AP Lit and Comp.
Hello, I'm Mrs. Piedemonte, and I teach special education.
Hi, I'm Mr. Alley. I teach social studies.
Hi, my name is Mrs. Somers, and I teach business courses.
Hi, I'm Ms. Nelson, and I'm new to Green Valley High School. I teach social and academic strategies, and then I co-teach language arts 2 and biology.
Hi, my name is Mindy Spencer, and I teach biology, pre-AP bio, and AP bio.
I'm Miss Miller, and I teach English language arts.
Hi, I'm Mrs. House, and I teach the Life Directions program.
I'm Mr. Kurtz, and I teach Algebra 1, Geometry, and Algebra 2.
Hi, Pete Carpino. I teach strength and conditioning.
Now back to you guys in the studio.
Well, there you have it, and that's all for today's episode. Make sure to like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter at GVHS Eagles Media. I'm Isaiah Akers.
And I'm Alex Franks.
Have a good day, Eagles.